Hey, what's up, fellas? How you doing? Matt Antonelli here. Now, we talk a lot about how rough the minor leagues can be, from travel to food and pretty much everything else. But there is one really exciting day for minor league players, and we're going to get into that now. So Jacob deGrom pitched in a low A rehab game last night, and well, he was pretty good, as you can imagine. He was throwing 102 miles per hour. He struck out everyone but like one guy. That must have been really fun for the opposing team's hitters. Now, the one cool thing about that is, if you're a hitter, you can tell your grandchildren one day that you struck out to Jacob deGrom in a low A baseball game. Actually, scratch that. Don't mention the low A part. Just tell them that back in the day you struck out to Jacob deGrom, and they'll think you played at least one day in the big leagues. Now, this actually happened to me way back in the day. My first at bat as a high A player. We were playing against the Rancho Cucamonga Quakes or something like that. I'm super excited to start my season. Well, guess who's on the mound for the Quakes? The legendary Bartolo Colon, making a rehab start for the Angels there. Now, he's throwing the nastiest cutter two-seam combination I've ever seen, and I start the season off 0-for-2 with two Ks. He was absolutely disgusting, but just like those players last night facing DeGrom, I can tell my kids and grandchildren that Bartolo Colon struck me out both times I faced them. And again, I'm not going to let them know it was a high A game. Anyways, what are we talking about this for? Well, last night on Twitter, Michael Mayer, I believe that's how you pronounce it, he sent out this tweet. It said, Jacob deGrom bought the entire St. Louis Mets team Chick-fil-A for their pregame meal today. And a lot of people were saying, wow, that is awesome. Wow, what a nice guy that Jacob is. And I bet you he is a great guy. But I want to give you some insight into how often this happens, because it actually does happen quite often. So first, let's talk about rehab starts and what they are. If you're a major league player and you get injured, if you've been on the DL for a bit and you need a couple of starts, or maybe you're a position player and you need a couple of at-bats before jumping back into the big leagues, because let's be honest, if you've been sitting on your sofa for a while, it's probably not a good idea to put you right back in the major leagues. So the team's going to let you go rehab your injury against some minor league players, get your confidence up, make them feel terrible about themselves. And this can really happen at every level. So don't think that if you're a major league or rehabbing, you're going to automatically go to AAA. You might go to low A. You might go to high A. Really, it kind of depends on where those games are. If you're a major league team in New York and your low A team is, let's say, also close to New York, you might go there. Now, in this instance, it was at the spring training complex of the Mets, so they send DeGrom down there to play. Now, when this happens, it's very common, and I would actually say it's expected, that that major league player is going to provide food for the entire team. And depending on how good the player is and how rich they are, that food can get pretty good. Now, usually this occurs in the last day before that player goes back to the big leagues. So if they're there for a week, they're probably not going to buy food every single day for the team, unless you're Brian Giles, because when Brian Giles rehabbed at high A when I was there in 2007, he bought us food every single night. What a guy Brian Giles is. Now, as a minor leaguer, anytime you hear that a major leaguer's coming down to rehab, you get all excited, because it means you won't have to eat peanut butter and jelly sandwiches for the 15th day in a row, and you might actually get some steaks and lobster. Now, during my time in the minor leagues, I've actually had a good amount of big leaguers rehabbing on my teams, from Brian Giles to Steven Strasburg to Ryan Zimmerman. There's a bunch of others that we could name as well. And the best meals I ever received was when Brian Giles was rehabbing with our team. He was a great, great guy, and he also had made about $100 million by the time he was rehabbing, so he decided to buy us dinner every single night. And on the last night before he went back to the big leagues, he actually had Outback Steakhouse come. They brought their grills, they were cooking us steaks, there was cheese fries for everyone, onion blooms, coconut shrimp. It was amazing. And when I got up to the big leagues the next year in 2008, Brian Giles was still on the team, and he did basically the same thing for the major league team. He would do sushi night, where he'd have a sushi chef come and have sushi laid out for the entire team. It was unbelievable. Again, I said it, what a guy Brian Giles is. So that's how it works. In case you're wondering, in case you hear this story again, now you know how it works when big leaguers come down to rehab. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment section below. Subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, give it a thumbs up, all that good stuff. I'm going to Outback. I want an onion bloom. If you've enjoyed this video and want to learn more about building the elite swing, check out our new course. We have over 2 hours of content, almost 30 hitting drills. We break down the exact mechanics that you're going to want to implement into your swing. I've put the link in the description if you want to go check it out.